much.
Oh, good.
Okay, sorry.
Let's make some noise for all the drummers and singers. Okay, at this time we're gonna pass the mic over to our guest, the conga. Let's make some noise. Let's make some noise.
Is anything good?
Thank you so much, Malo Aupito, for the opportunity to be here today with you. Before we get started, as our children get ready to perform for you today, this evening, and share our culture with you, we want to present a gift to the chairwoman of Tuvalu. And thanking you for the opportunity to be here this evening. And so, I want to start off our speech. Give a mama to the Kuna. Give fire to the Kuna. Go and tell them about the Mua. May the Emahu Rahma. Ne to the Kap to the Kuna. O for the Kuna, the Ne Oluna. That thou to follow Hangeha Una. That your master poets and keepers of history of the land might hear me. That we might be permitted to share a brief history of where we come from. For it is a story from long ago, from the very first of our kind. The land, it was blessed, and it was darkened from above, and we emerged as hermit crabs. Like hermit crabs who carry their homes on their backs, so has been the story of our navigation history for Tongan people, as Chairwoman Terry Bowman said, over 5,700 miles away from here. We have come out to your shores, and we are grateful for the welcoming that you have presented for us today, and we dry our feet here on your shores with gratitude. And today we would like to present our emblems. This here is our tapa cloth. It is the fabric of our culture, made by a village, by the bark of our trees, the mulberry bush bark. On it printed is the sila of Kona, or the coat of arms, and the various markings that say, Otua mo Kona kohoku tofia, God and Kona are our inheritance. We meet here on Tulalip Nation land, and to all of our Coast Salish brothers and sisters, to present to you humbly our sila, that we might be able to seek refuge on your land. We are taking this all back, decolonizing the history books, because 50 years we have existed here in Seattle, Washington, as a community. But we are now finally having an opportunity to acknowledge our indigenous people of the land that we live on today. And we thank you. Thank you wholeheartedly for allowing us to be here with you this evening. And since 50 years ago as well. We also have for you a ta'amoa, or called kumete, kabapo. It is the compass that our navigators use. Inside it, we usually follow the roots of the kaba tree. For it is said in Tonga that when you die, from your head grows kaba. That's the knowledge and wisdom of your ancestors to be passed on. And from your feet grows the sugar cane to reminisce the sweet things of life that follow. So as you see our young men and women that in the Kabataamoa circle over there, you're more than welcome to join. We are drinking of the knowledge of our ancestors and reminiscing about the sweet things that they have left for us. We also present to you, not like our colonizers have come before to clap their flags, but we present to you our flag of Toma to seek refuge on your land. And we thank you very much. Thank you very much wholeheartedly for all of this. Tauhi e koloa koe ni. Thank you.
as they present. We thank you, Chairwoman Terry Golden, for the opportunity to be here and for the hospitality you have shown us. And to the Tulela Nation and all of our co-sailors present, we thank you humbly from the bottom of our hearts. As we move forward now in our program, we are going to go into our first performance. The performance we are going to perform right now is our opening number. It is called Emao Lubulu. This is a sitting dance. And this sitting dance usually depicts a story of navigators when they first arrived. The drum beat usually is because of the beat. It keeps the steady of the rope. And also the action, they tell the story. So I invite now my performers to please take a position, my loyal people.
Thank you.
Malo, malo, thank you. We're going to take it now to our next number. Our next number is what's been the spirit that actually led us to be here. And it's in honoring of our one of our common brothers, named Rico Colbeto. He used to play in our hall every first Thursday and last Thursday of the month. And this performance is actually by two young virgin women. And usually it's called a Kawaruma. But it's for two Gaukoa, I guess you could call it. But this song is called Fumasia, and the song is actually written about leaving home, Tonga, and always having it on our mind. And for many of us, we've all left Tonga, and we found refuge in other places, especially here in your lands, Coast Salish lands. And so, where Ulisse is buried is in what the chairperson told, chairwoman told me, was supposed to be evidence in the treaty. And I acknowledge that today. I acknowledge that that's still part of your land, because that is where Ulisse is buried. And because he's buried there, his body is now one with your land, and now it is a very sacred place now to us. And so I've come also with our kids and grandkids and great-grandkids of our very first that actually arrived. And so now I ask our ladies to take their place, and they're going to perform for you. Both of them, the composer who wrote the song and made it famous, Ulisse, he has passed away. And also, the one who choreographed this dance is Loleto Suibai, Halemaka Suibai. She has also passed away and is buried here in Coast Salish land. So this dance is very special, and I hope you enjoy it. Malo.
Thank you.
So while we catch the, while the boys go catch their breath, I'm going to, my little DJ, I'm going to tell a quick story about Kaaba, because Kaaba is what you see going on up here. And like I have mentioned earlier, it is a route that we have from the island, and we ground it. But the story goes that Kaaba actually originated from a little girl. The king, once upon a time, there was a famine on the islands. And it's customary in Tongan culture, when we have guests arrive, especially someone of high status, like the king or the high chief, when they arrive on your shores, you have to prepare something. Well, for Mama and for Papa, to the man and the woman, they ran all over the island looking for something to feed the chief, the king. They couldn't find nothing to feed him. What they found was the only bitter taro root left on the whole island. And underneath it, the king or the chief was sleeping in the shade of its leaves. So they returned.
They returned home.
Oh, there we go. And when they returned home, they looked and they were sad in their kitchen because they had nothing to prepare. They had a daughter who had leprosy, and her name was Kaaba. And what Kaaba said was, you know what, Mom and Dad, I'm looking at you. You guys look so stressed out right now, trying to find something to feed this person. I have an idea. And they said, what is your idea? She said, kill me and put me into the umu, which is the underground oven, and bake me and serve me as a meal for the king. The Bama and the Papa were so sad that their daughter actually would offer something like this. And they looked around to the left, looked to the right, they couldn't find nothing to actually offer, and they said, are you sure, our daughter Papa? She said, yes, good. So Kaaba, they killed her, and they put her inside the umu, and they cooked her. When the king woke from his slumber underneath the big taro root, the bitter taro root, he looked over and he seen her. He seen what the two had done, and he told them, don't unearth the umu. It is a gesture of love that you have done. Keep it. Many weeks later, two plants grew from where Kaaba was buried. From the head grew the Kaaba root, and from the feet grew the dough, or the sugar cane. One chief brought this to the king, and the king said, you know what? We're going to make a ceremony of this to commemorate it, to make it a Tongan thing. So in Tonga, the king said, because your daughter sacrificed herself, I'm going to instill these values in my people, and these behaviors are what's going to make them known to be Tongans. Ones who practice love, respect, nurturing relationships, who would be willing to make a sacrifice for a willing cause, worthy cause, and to serve through humility. So when we drink Kaaba, it's not just drinking Kaaba to get drunk like some people believe. For us, it's actually drinking the land, drinking Dona back home, and drinking this knowledge and wisdom. So that, we invite you all, later as this night progresses, we will have Kaaba circles around, and we freely give it to you to participate with us and enjoy. Our next dance that we're going to have, it is called the Mako, and it's a dance done by single young men. And what they do is they go out into the bush and they pick flowers, make lays to give to their significant other. And so, yeah. We also make lays to present or pick flowers to give to the highest person in our family, which is our paternal auntie. So whoever your daddy is, the oldest sister, the oldest sister has the highest rank. She's known as the Fahu in our family. So women have a very high status in our family. So I know I've talked too long, and I believe our boys are ready. I'm going to turn this time over to them. Thank you. Thank you, boys. Our next dance. This dance usually is reserved for the highest status person in the family or in a function. It's called Pitawoluma. And this dance, we reserved it actually for the highest person that we chose within our group. Is our punake, or our master poet who taught all of these numbers. It is his daughter that we chose to be the highest one of our dancers to perform this. So this Kawaluma, it talks about Fakafia Fria Itaufe Loaki, which means it is such a beautiful thing to gather together like this in peace and love. And that is exactly what this song talks about. This song, we are very thrilled to be here with Kunela and also our other co-sailors, brothers and sisters in the building. We thank you again, and thank you for this opportunity to share this with you. Mahalo.
Thank you.
Alright. Here we go. Sorry. Our last number that we're going to present for you, the tribute thank you, is a song that was composed by our Punake Talibulangi Hepa, his mother, Kui Malakaho. Kui Malakaho was handpicked by the late Queen Salokitipo III to sit in the palace and compose music and choreograph dances to entertain the royal majesty in the house of the Royal House of Goma. We are very blessed and very honored to have Talibulangi Hepa with us here in Coast Salish lands to continue that legacy in passing that knowledge on to our children. This song is called Taulama o Nuku Alofa, and it talks about the shores of Nuku Alofa, which is the capital of Tomatapu. So if you see where the flag is, or the map, inside the middle over there, that harbor, that's the capital right where, close by where the cross is at, in the middle section. So this song talks about the waters and its beauty. And every time Tongans, all of the Tongans that you see here, every Tongan in the world, they are able to connect their family lineage back to that crown and that royal house because they intermarried their royal chiefs, which are the elders of ours, of us. And so all of them, they have the actual right to be called the king and the queen and the royal house. But this song and dance is going to be a boys and girls dance. And it talks about, like I mentioned what it talks about, usually they will call this a laka laka, but it's not a laka laka. Laka laka is actually a sung speech and dance composed, but this is something similar, like a mock laka laka. So I thank you again for the opportunity, and I give this time over to our guests. Malo.
Thank you.
Linda would say, Aho, thank you so much, Mahalo Aupito, for letting us dry our feet and to take off our sails and to honor your land today. Thank you very much for the opportunity. I give the mic back now to the DJ or to the MC, and I thank you in peace and love and harmony.
Make some noise for our conga relatives here. Once again, we want to thank them for coming out, raising their hands, each and every one of them. And our prayers are your prayers. Once again, let's make some noise for the conga one more time. Call up Wazi Kena, Andrew Wogan. I'm going to share a couple of words here.